So, hello lovely people, welcome to this brand new year and welcome to a brand new edition of Wednesday Wellbeing. We've done it because it was so popular last year and then I got sidetracked and did something else. So here we are again. In actual fact, slight change, I'm just going to do it from here. It's quite comfortable, it's alright here, have a cup of tea. I don't have to ferry around to all different places, so I'm going to do it from here. Another difference is going to be, is this is going to be primarily aimed at teachers. So that you guys can look after your own well-being and then pass the information on through your classes and through your children, and dare I say, even some of the parents might even want to know some of these things that I'm talking about. So without further ado, let's crack on. This week's edition is all about self-belief. I can't say that in 3 minutes. There's no way I can talk about self-belief in 3 minutes. So bear with me, because you probably will not know any of this. When I go into schools, I'm going to be honest with you, straight away, most teachers will list a number of things that I need to focus on. And almost all the time, just children just don't believe in themselves. People just don't believe in themselves anymore. Where does that come from, and why don't we believe in ourselves? In fact, some people make out they believe in themselves, in actual fact, they probably don't. And this is because when we, the brain's default mechanism, and it comes to recognize us as us through experiences. So let's say, I don't know, I'm 51, so I've been on this earth 51 years, and all of my experiences up to today, my brain recognizes as me. Got that? Easy. But when I look in a mirror, I see a physical form looking back at me. Sometimes I'm heavier than I really want to be. Sometimes I'm skinny. Sometimes I've got more muscles. Sometimes I like myself, and sometimes I just don't like myself, you know? And this is another thing that can stop me believing in myself. When I look in the mirror, or when we look in the mirror, sometimes we think, I don't like this person looking back at me. So straight away, we're on the back foot. So we need to eliminate the idea that other external things, let's say governments, media, social media, other externals, opinions of us, just happen to be a load of rubbish, actually. Otherwise, we'd all end up doing exactly what the government tells us, and hang on, aren't we doing that already? Okay, I'm not going to get started on that. We are doing that, but that then limits us, our belief in ourselves. So let's go straight to the jugular. You and I are wanting to do Kilimanjaro. Kilimanjaro is 19,000 feet, by the way, and there's a lack of oxygen up there. Lots of people do Kilimanjaro. It's in Africa, and off we do. And off we go, and we're really looking forward to it. We're physically trained for it, we're mentally ready for it, we're emotionally ready, we're financially ready. But do we believe that we can do it? So we tell ourselves that we can do it. The best thing to do in preparation, let's just stick with Kilimanjaro, the best thing to do for preparation is to first of all get to know ourselves. Check that out. Get to know ourselves. What are we capable of? Can we even do this? And if the answer is, I'm not sure, guess what's gonna happen? You're probably gonna fail. If it's, I don't think so, because some family member said that they knew somebody who did it and it was so cold that they did that, and then that goes into your head. So basically, if we listen to external things, that will stop us believing in ourselves based on their experience. I'm listening to a guy at the moment, Master Shiren He. He is a Shaolin master. And he tells a wonderful story about a man at the bottom of a mountain who wants to see the top of the mountain. And off he goes on this journey. And as he sets off, he sees a traveler who's coming down from the mountain. And he says to this traveler, you know, what's the best way up the mountain? And the guy says, well, actually, you know, you can go that way, that way. 5 minutes later, he sees another traveler and he says, would you tell me, you know, what's the road like on the path up there? So he tells him what it's like. So this guy sits back down and gets back up to start the journey. And then someone else comes down and he says, you couldn't do me a favor, could you tell me the view from the top? And so this person tells him what the view looks like. And then all of a sudden this guy thinks to himself, well, hang on, I know what the road's like. I know the best way to go up. And I know what it looks like at the top. I don't really need to go. Well, actually, that's not completely right, is it? Because there is no clarity and inner harmony and perfection of human nature than standing on top of a mountain with the complete clarity that you are alive. So, dare I say it? That's what we need to do. We need to stop listening to other people's opinions of us. And also, the second most important thing is stop listening to the negative things that we say to ourselves in our head. There was one of my most beautiful people who's ever graced the face of the earth, a guy called Lao Tzu, and he said, we should, and I'll quote, we should let go of labels, which is what the mind has come to recognize as us. Let go of labels as what the mind has come to recognize as us, and be careful what we whisper to ourselves on a daily basis. And that is, you get up in the morning and you tell yourself, oh, I'm not really in the mood for this. I don't really want to go to work. It's raining. Oh, I'm just going to stay in bed. I don't feel very well. I don't like my job. I mean, and we tell ourselves and we convince ourselves that that is our life. That thought will then manifest itself into an emotion, and the emotion manifests into an action. And then guess what? We don't have a particularly good day because we've pretty much convinced ourselves of that. I think it was Abraham Lincoln who said, we are as happy as we make our minds out to be. So, in order to believe in ourselves, firstly, we need to recognize ourselves and realize that we have the capability, and you're gonna love this, we have the capability to, no matter how old we are, to change our brain chemistry. And that is something called neuroplasticity, which is we are the sum total of all our experience up to this point. But if we want something in the future, then we need to make ourselves look like the thing in the future. Does that make sense? We're not going to do Kilimanjaro if we look back because we've got no experience of doing it. So the self-belief, we need to, first of all, eliminate negativity, eliminate the negative things externally around us. Go to a quiet place, meditate, focus on who we are with this internal inquiry, so we know who we are, not what the brain has come to recognize who we are, not what your father thinks you are really like, not what your mother thinks you're like, or your friends think you're like. What do you feel that you are like? And you and we and us can change that every single day. That's the easy part. The hard part is, it's hard. It is hard to change the path that we've been on, because the brain also likes being comfortable. And with that, we like being nice and warm. We like being fed, we like being nice water, and so on and so forth. And that is us, and the brain will always protect us and keep us safe, and that's what it will automatically go to all of the time. And guess what? It's not warm at the top of Kilimanjaro. It's cold, it's horrible, you know, it's windy, it's snowy, it might be minus 20. But how on earth do we ever gonna know ourselves unless we put ourselves in that situation? But at some point, we need to stop looking at the trainers on the floor and get them on and do it. Don't tell people what we're gonna do. We just show them our results, and that comes from self-belief, really. Not just on the external, not putting on something on social media, I'm gonna do this because I'm fitter than I've ever been. Don't bother with that. Let's just do it. And that doing will come from focus, eliminating negative thoughts, going to a quiet room, finding out who we are, and then experiencing something new, which will be through the avenue of pain and suffering and hardship. You can't do it? You already have. Because any single adversity that we've ever faced in our lives, we can build from. So if we've lost loved ones, if we've lost relationships, if we've been ill ourselves, that was us having hardships. So if we've done that, we can do whatever it is we want to do. So let's say we do make it to the top of Kilimanjaro, or we do make it to the top of whatever, or we do that marathon, and then we've got that experience. That itself then starts to build our self-belief. And then 2 years later, I don't know, might be in hospital, we might be ready for an operation, and you're scared, it's 4 hours and you're gonna be in surgery, and then somebody says, are you scared? And you think, actually, yeah, I am scared, I'm gonna have my appendix out, or whatever it is, and then all of a sudden you remember, boom, you are the person that's still on the top of Kilimanjaro at 19,500 feet. I can do anything. So self-belief comes from experiences, and it comes from putting our shoes on and making it happen and not talking about it. Last but not least, it's important for children to have a mentor. At the moment, I'm reading about a guy called Davy Goggins. He is incredible. This guy is one of the hardest, baddest mans on the planet. He is my inspiration. We all need a mentor. So we need something to strive towards. We need somebody to drive us, and we need a hero. We seem to be attached to superheroes that don't really exist. Why don't we attach ourselves to the people that we do respect and we do want to really be like? And that's not necessarily Batman, Superman, and Spider-Man, because those guys are fictional characters. So we can use mentors like, I don't know, for me, Shackleton, Reinhold Messner, Sir David Attenborough, Stephen Hawking, Gandhi, Mother Teresa. These are my heroes, John Lennon. These are the people that inspire me. But inspiration lies in every single time you put your foot on the floor and it's heading in that direction. It doesn't come from me sitting comfortably with a cup of tea reading about it. Do you get me? So today's lesson plan, I want you, if you can, to write, or get the children to write, the pupils to write something about what they think self-belief is. And why don't we have a little workshop where we can have a talk about how much self-belief they've actually got, and if they've not got any, where can they get it from and how it can be achieved. If you've got any questions, hit my inbox, and I will be happy to help the school sort of free of charge through this format. And that is pretty much it. Be careful what you tell yourself. Constantly evolve, constantly move forward. Stop listening to governments and media and families and friends telling them what they think you are. Find out yourself, step forward, put your shoes on, go for it, get that experience, and that will build up your self-belief. Until next time, I'll see you in a couple of weeks. You take it easy, take care out there. Hey, and good luck climbing that mountain. See you later.